guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's video, we have a special guest.
Damn, I'm so honored to be here. It's been a while.
I know, my beautiful husband.
Just want to talk about Max. I forgot who the dad is or what.
Not even. But we are going to be finally filming our playlist. So I think everybody was actually thinking that you were going to come in and show everybody your Bad Bunny playlist, because that's all literally
you listen to. I really do.
But we are going to be doing a playlist para los enamorados y los heartbroken.
And the desamor ones. You have to play those.
The heartbroken, because Ulises decided to throw that in there. I don't even know why. It was supposed to be a cute video.
It's funny because when we used to play these in the... So there was a time where she didn't really like banda as much, but I exposed her more to it when we started dating. So I used to play a lot of the desamor ones just because I like them. Some of them are just good. But it's funny because we would get in arguments like, wow, nice playlist you had today. Like, it was
because
funny.
He would like go on, what would you go on, like on Snapchat? Was there Snapchat back then? No, right? Where you would post it?
And maybe I'll post it or.
And then I would be like, really, you had to post that song? Like, it would even trigger like
playing,
more of a bigger.
I would just play it.
Yeah.
In the car.
Or he'll like say we would be arguing and he would play and he'd hella put it up all of a sudden, like he wanted me to listen to that freaking song.
She never listened though, so it didn't really matter.
No, but I'm gonna take you guys literally through memory lane of back then when Ulises used to dedicate the cutest songs to me. Now he can't dedicate shit to me because all he listens to is Bad Bunny and this is gonna tell me about a fucking cheating song. That's about it.
Yeah.
But now all of the songs that we're gonna show you guys is literally our playlist that we would listen to all the time when we were dating. Like, he would listen to these songs all the time, send them to me through text messages. And
Little
then
parts.
Yeah, so the first few songs are gonna be like really nice, cute songs, and then we'll kind of show you guys, I mean, tell you guys what they remind us of, if there is like a story behind it. And then the last songs are Ulises's playlist.
What do you guys want to send to that person? Like, listen to this shit.
And he has his own little playlist of when apparently I broke his heart, because... But you didn't mean them, right, babe?
Yeah, I did. That's why right now I was playing them. I was like, damn.
Shut up. Lonely
nights. And I would turn and I would just feel a pillow like, oh, shit, nobody's here.
You're dumb. We weren't even together like that.
I'm playing my little ass bed.
You mean... He means like driving and he probably didn't see anybody on the passenger side. That's about it. But we're going
to
show you guys.
So I haven't listened to a lot of these songs in a long time because I stopped listening to like banda, corridos, all that just because... I got into the whole like Latin trap stuff and I just found a new music genre, so I was like, you know what, whatever, I got over the whole banda thing, but it's always cool to go back.
Is our first one.
I think we weren't like hella like lovey-dovey yet with this one, but
this is
dedicated.
Yeah, this is the song that every time I listen to it reminds me of him because he would play it when you would drop me off. Remember, like literally right before you're about to drop me off, like you would always play this song. Was it this one? It was this one, right?
I don't know. Ask yourself.
Shut up. Great. My relationship is about to be tested right now because Ulises remembers everything and I don't remember shit.
Shouldn't
so.
You remember what you did yesterday, huh?
All these songs to him now. I know, it's about
time. I used to be like, not a Marte yet, but like, you
know. He would tell me, like, he would dedicate songs that say, like, I love you already in them, and then he would be like, making it sure that I knew that it wasn't weird that he was sending that to me because he just really, really, really liked me.
But yeah. It's kind of hard in the beginning because you're like, fuck, when do I say it type of thing. But
it's cute because Ulises literally, like, exactly how he was looking at me right now. Like, I remember him back in the day and he would just be like, staring at me to see if I was like, what I was thinking about that song. Oh, this one was one that I read that
this
I didn't remember.
This one was right in the beginning.
Yeah, until he mentioned it and then I was like, oh yeah.
Just because she was all unsure if she should date a little young nigga, you know?
Roberto Tapia was our fucking, well, at least my, like, I love Roberto Tapia. This vez no es el momento, tal vez todo a su tiempo, pero lo que por ti
esto no lo puedo traer adentro.
There's another song from that album.
Pensaba enamorarme, pero te conocí.
That's pretty much it. So, try to get to the not love you ones, you know?
Shut up! This one was a really nice song too, that you used to sing the song to.
Oh, right here.
We used to listen to Noel Torres a lot.
Yeah, he was tight.
Noel Torres, Remy Valenzuela, and Roberto Tapia was like my guys.
Shit, yeah.
So this song was, this is the one that he would dedicate all the time. Yeah. Every time we would hang out, literally all the time. Because he was saying, Que el tiempo conmigo. It's the best time he's ever had, you know? I know.
You have to sing it to me.
En verdad, que me siento tan justo.
Carnaval was really good too for a while.
No me equivoqué cuando te elegí. Las cosas buenas has traído para.
I think I know why.
This
one was good.
This one just dedicates a song to me, and it will low key make me kind of mad. It's saying like that you don't care about anybody else but me, but. You're saying like I'm celosa. I remember I used to be like I'm not celosa.
Oh,
I don't care.
That's right.
Esto que mañana empiezas a extrañarme. Apuesto que mañana buscas la manera de decirme que no es cierto que me odias. Siempre te pones así si llego tarde. Pero lo que todavía tú no asimilas. Es que yo te amo tanto como a nadie. Mírate, que no ves que eres más linda que una estrella. No ves que eres más linda que la luna. Tu amor es lo más grande. Tu amor es mi fortuna.
Alright, so now we're gonna get to the good stuff. There's very few songs, but
I love how you're more
a lot
excited
of meaning behind it.
About the heartbroken ones than the cute ones.
Yeah, exactly. Did I not have the right?
Did I break your heart, honey?
She doesn't believe me.
Aww.
So there was a time when we broke up a little bit, and she wanted to get back with me, of course. And then
like, you're so funny.
I was making it a little hard for her. I would just send her songs because she would do the same damn thing too before. So this
we would
how
just
it went.
Send songs to each other.
So she wasn't sure she wanted to be with me, so then like she didn't know how to tell me, so she was sending me fucking songs, and while they're trying to listen to the song, like, I wonder what she's really trying to say. Cause you know guys are just slow to shit sometimes. So I'm over there trying to catch things in the songs, right? And then whatever, we ended up working out, but then
he would just listen to the music.
I think eventually she we just called it like quits, and then yeah. I mean, just like anybody.
It was like a week.
That whole week he had a new song. It was a damn month. It was not a month, babe.
Maybe it felt like a month.
We broke up like sometime in December. We didn't get back till like January.
You
text me on New Year's.
No,
how the hell do you know?
It was like,
yes, no.
Babe, we broke up like around Christmas.
Yes, and you didn't text. No, yeah. It was a week or 2 weeks before Christmas.
Not even, we spent Christmas together. We didn't spend Christmas not together.
Yes.
We didn't spend Christmas together?
You guys have to believe me. She doesn't remember anything.
And then
after that, on New Year's, I went out. And yeah, she texted me like that next day or something. But a friend of mine at the time went to the bank, and I think your sister asked her.
That
like,
doesn't
oh,
make
doing?
Sense. That doesn't make sense. Whatever. I don't remember. No, I could.
Even more I reason could. To play the song.
Perdón, porque voy a caer. No me inventes mentiras que voy a creer. No me hables con cara de arrepentir. La verdad parece rompecabezas en mi corazón en pedazos. No me pidas.
I'm sure that time didn't feel long for her. It was a fucking long ass month.
Oh, baby.
Like,
oh, so
like 2 weeks. was. That's what I told her, okay? And then since she was stubborn, I played her this song.
First of all, this is such a sad song. You should never dedicate this song to anybody.
Shut up. There's another one.
I feel like I'm being attacked.
Te arrepientes tú de haberme conocido. Que ya no cumplo para ti los requisitos.
And then we got back together and then we played this song. Because she always all drunk all the time.
Yeah. You know what? This song, it definitely fit me because I was going through my little drunk stage. I just think I drink a lot now. You guys should have met me back then. But I was going through like my really drunk stage, so.
Yeah, she didn't want a relationship.
Nope, I wanted a party.
Oh, just there hanging on a little thread.
Okay, guys, cute. Let me defend myself, okay? Like, I had just gotten out of a long relationship, and then I didn't drink.
We were already together for a while.
Right, but I hadn't drank in, like, since ever. I was, ever. Like, I waited till I was 21 years old to drink for the first time, and I met him when I was 20. And I didn't go out because, like, I was in a relationship, and then my mom, she was like super strict, so like I would never do anything. So then when I got with him, he was so chill, and he was like, yeah, baby, have fun. So now I have fun.
Take advantage.
You know, so then like I would go out, and like he would be my DD, and like I wanted to party. You let me live, baby. You let me be happy. You let me live. You let me be me.
Only for a little bit.
You should be happy.
And then it went overboard. She was like, you know what, I'm moving out, and I think I'm just gonna be single. Shit.
Oh my god, baby.
She was all nervous.
She was like, well, I was gonna tell you. But look at us now. We're amazing. We're happy, right? We're happy, right?
There was more, actually. I just forgot him, but I'm playing. Hopefully you guys got to see.
I love how I am the in love one and he was the heartbroken one over here. So excited to show you guys and expose me. This video should be called Exposing Yvette Exo instead
the
of
the real Yvette Exo.
Yeah, instead of like Los Enamorados playlist.
Behind closed doors.
Babe, tell them something nice about me. Tell them you love me.
I don't know why I love her.
Wow.
I love her.
I went through my face, guys.
You know, it's funny because I feel like, I don't know, it's weird. Like, we went through all that, but now it's just better because we got all that stuff out of the way.
And it was just like,
because we really don't even argue.
One time that we went through that in the 6 years.
Does that
mean
more?
No, but I'm saying, like, imagine the couples that literally break up and go out.
I feel bad for the people that fight all the time.
Yeah. Like, break up and go out. Get break. Like, we did it once, and he was clearly very affected by it.
Well, yeah, I mean...
For us, we really don't even, like, argue anymore, but that was a stage in our life.
You guys enjoyed the video. Let us know what you think. She'll be tagging the songs below, so you guys can dedicate it to all the people you want.
Especially Lisa's playlist, I'm sure. Thank you guys all so much for watching our video. I hope you guys enjoyed our playlist. And we will see you guys on our next video. Love you guys.
Peace. No me equivoqué.